Xi Xian obviously will be a big favourite here, but of course she's up against a very experienced player in Ip Wien. And of course we've still got more men's doubles to come with some home hopes with Bowen Mogensen up against the Singaporean pair of Chris Nanta and Tri Chat. First out, followed by Wang Xixian. Well, it's a dangerous opponent in some respect, isn't she, Ip Wien? She still thinks she can challenge for medals, and of course, there's always pressure on the likes of Wang, particularly given, you know, the way she's had these ups and downs in her career.
Yeah, she's a wonderful character to watch play. One of the few girls that uses the jump smash.
So the number two seed hit, the number two player in the world, Wang Xixian, up against the 27-year-old from Hong Kong, who played in her first World Championships back in 2005. You can see ranked 24 in the world. She has been as high as 8, but she's been happy with her training and the way things have been going. Been a pretty good year for Wang Xixian, ranked number 2. As you can see, played a lot of matches this year. Absolutely superb at the All England, beat Ishuwei, Wang Yihan, Sina Naiwell on her way to winning at the All England. Three straight Super Series finals at the Indian Open, beating Li Shuwei again. She hasn't won since, though. Not that that means she's doing bad form, but she lost in the final of the Asian Badminton Championships, the semi-final losses in Australia and Indonesia, as we look at Andrea Chiappini, who's our umpire. Former number one, they have met before. The previous meeting there, as you can see, straight games. 8th win out of 8 for Wang Xixian. 3 of those wins came last year. One of those, of course, as you can see, the China Open. First two meetings they had went to 3 games. It's been straight sets victories ever since for Wang Xixian. But I just wonder if we could put up a good fight here.
Well, she's always up for a fight. She's a very, as I said, she's a very cool character what's playing. But if you came from the outside and you've never watched them play before and you didn't know anything about badminton, if you saw that 8-0 sign, then you probably...
you wouldn't be putting your money on that.
Because one thing is that you're a good badminton player. Another thing is you lost 8 in a row. That means that on the third and fourth, you should be thinking, you know, you should have learned something and have come up with pretty much everything against this player you have played against, and we still have 4 more victories for Wang Xixian. So it's an uphill battle for her, I think.
Yeah, started the year very slowly. She did reach the semis in her last tournament at Chinese Taipei. She's been improving since the Uber Cup quarterfinal in Japan as well, and she's been back training now 6 days a week. She was mixing badminton with a part-time job and studying. She worked in a bakery. She's cut that back, and she's focused now purely on, you know, obviously these World Championships and the Asian Games coming up in Jump. So it'll be interesting to see whether she can step it up here. She's up against a classy opponent, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Service order. One. Love.
And while if we got to the quarterfinals at the Olympics, which was as good as anyone from Hong Kong's ever done at the Olympics before. Of course, Wang Shixian wasn't even there, which was rather surprisingly, really.
Yeah, but not when you saw the end result. I think China must have seen something when Li Shiwei was picked instead. So, and she of course went on to win the gold. So
she beat Yip Wei Yin on the way.
Yeah.
Two. Love.
A good start for Yip.
Yeah, it's difficult, isn't it? You know, obviously there are sponsors involved, and you know, badminton players can earn decent money, but you know, obviously you want to supplement it. It's not like you can retire on that money either. You know, she's got this business going on, she's got studies going on. It's hard to then say, okay, I'm gonna, you know, what's she, 27 now? Let's commit a couple of years to playing badminton, and that she's fired up. And you know, you'd think it's normal that you'd be focused purely on the badminton, but you know, people got to live as well, haven't they?
Yeah, definitely. And you know, coming from Denmark now, it has changed. That's become better. But I pretty much knew when I started playing badminton that you had to have an education and have a life on the side, because you couldn't live off what you earned in badminton. There was not that money in it. Now that is changed, and that's good, because that just gives us better badminton when players can focus fully on it. When that's in the set, I don't think it hurts, actually. I think you will have a lot of complete better players by educating themselves outside in life and in
that. Well, it makes them more rounded as individuals, doesn't it?
Yeah, complete individuals, yeah. So I like the idea, and I still think that's still being worked on it from a Danish point of view, that we would like the players to get an education on the side, go to school, but of course it has to be a mix. You can't prioritize it as much as badminton.
Just long for a mip there.
Two, three.
The last couple of world championships not really been at her best. She had to retire with a knee injury 2011. Second round, she lost to Ratchanok Intanon in round two. Third round, she lost to a Chinese player in 2010. She lost to Wang Lin.
Four, two.
But a good start from Yip here. Very aggressive and not afraid of really pushing the shuttles and taking the net and attacking when it's possible. So,
three, four.
But the big task for her here is she has to keep that going. You know, that's not okay to do in certain periods of the game. It has to be a complete game for her to win this one. But very aggressive. Oh, so then challenge it. Challenge it.
Yeah, she's looking to her coach now.
Challenge. Yeah, but it's too late. It's too late to challenge.
I don't know why she didn't challenge. Let's have a look at it on the replay here. That's a real suspicion. That was out, you know.
Yeah.
I don't know why she didn't challenge.
Some players haven't gotten used to it yet. I think one of the problems are that players over the many, many years now have been not brought up. That sounds badly, but when you're in there and you're in a fight, you want that extra edge. So you're used to actually trying to call that line yourself all the time. Instead of right now, you can't really call it anymore, because your opponent can basically just take a challenge. So she was reacting like the old times there. Instead of, if she thinks there's something, just get that hand up. Take that challenge.
Lovely shot, this from Wang.
That's amazing. And she's, you know, from the start that Yip has here, it's Wang Xiang is nice and comfortably taking the control of this match.
They are facing from Poland.
has a great shot, great drop shot.
Yeah, good quality at the start of this match. Wang, who's got the questioning looks. This court given out.
Please welcome technical officials on court number two. Okay.
That's wide.
She says she feels as passionate about the game now as she did as a teenager. It's hard to maintain that kind of thirst for the game. Now, what's going on here?
Yeah, he's telling her to be faster. The one problem for Yibi in that case is she's really speeding up the game in the rallies, and of course, that's very tiring, especially when you're playing Wang, because she's basically getting most of the shots back, so she maybe needs a little bit of a longer breather sometimes. You can see here, she's constantly in the attack, but he's still...
she's going to get a sore throat as well, isn't she?
Well, she's definitely sending a message that she believes in this, eh? Oh, fault, because it hit her. I see, you can see in the look on Wang there, what? She's saying, what? I'm not even close. And she wasn't even. So, but it's when the shuttle hits the opponent, then the umpire has to call a fault. Those are great drop shots that she has here. Oh, fantastic net shot. And that's, you know, that's what she needs to do. She needs to come in there with her great technique, see if she can take the net. Look at that. That is absolutely perfect.
Impossible to retain.
Yeah, and that would be difficult to do the full game, but she needs, you know, she needs to show that she's able to do it. But she's sending a message. She's really, really showing a bit of attitude there that she believes in this.
Questions here for Wang Shixian, isn't there?
Definitely.
Just to remind you, 8 previous meetings, 8 wins for Wang. Last 6 of them in straight games.
Thank you. 8, 9.
turns white.
Serve is over. Ken. Eight.
She's really funny.
Oh, and she got the better luck. Her efforts
well
deserved, really.
Deserved, yeah. She's really, really going for it. But that, it's a hard, hard rally.
And what a point for her to win. Oh, very well getting that back, but then staying in the point as well, remaining focused.
And there, she had to go for it. She had no power left. No, 3 point gap here, it's good.
Yep, we in 11-8 to the good.
One 20 seconds.
She's really going for that drop shot.
Serve is over. Nine.
As soon as she has the chance, she's using the front court. Wang Xihan has seen the desperate shots that Yip has used in this match that she's really going for. That kind of indicates for her also that Yip is not willing to really rally. So she knows that the more rallies she can get in there, the more the odds will turn in her favor. Basically, she's just trying to keep her away from the net now. She just punches those clears down in the back corner and the lift down there, and then Yip has to start from down there. And now you can see the suffering is starting. Oh, that's a great backhand. It's a very, very, very hard rally, this one.
Yeah, but the fact that she's able to train now full time, as she's been saying, and
yeah,
6 days a week, and it will help her.
Definitely, but I just don't still think that. In a game with a lot of rallies, I still think Wang Xihan will come out on top. So I don't think it will be in her favor. That's why I really have liked the start that she has shown here. She never really uses the smash one. As we can see, she's only going long or really short. good defense there. But a very hard rally again for Yip. She down that backhand side. She almost got that one over. Yeah, and you can see Yip holding her knees there.
Yeah, 4 points in a row for Wang here.
Second time now, so she's got to be careful. This shows you what I'm saying, that she's probably feeling the pressure of these rallies that Wang is playing. And we have these ones, and oh, amazing. But the clear down to that round the head side all the time. Oh, there. Oh. Well, you need luck of that. She needed that.
I think Wang was trying to claim whether she actually crossed over as she played this.
Oh, she has a case.
Yeah.
How did Wang get that one over? That's amazing. But again, if you see, it's that clear, that really heavy punch clear down to that round head side on Yip that forces her to do something. You know, she can't hit it away from there, so she's playing the front court, and Wang is already standing up there, so very hard for her. There again. So she's really, really punishing her to that backhand side. Again, that's 5 shots in a row to her backhand side.
That's a little short. Oh.
No net luck this time.
Serve is over. 13. 12.
That's a problem for
14,
for Yip.
12.
She baits. She really, really don't want to give Wang that gap. She wants to keep it tight all the way up, where she maybe could go for it at the end of the game. So now it's vital that she will get this next point. Or else I think it's going to be very, very difficult for Yip to come back in this game.
It's been tight throughout this opening game.
Oh, that's a fantastic curl. Spin shot.
Serve is over. 15, 13.
She worked the point really well too. It'd be very frustrating for Ipuet dip there.
You can see Wang has seen that drop shot now, and she just punches it down that round the head side, and then when Yip is a little bit too close attached to that round the head side, she comes in with these drops. That's good. That's good challenge.
Yeah, challenge has come.
Wang Yang challenge. Call out.
I definitely don't think it was wide. It's not wide.
It could be long.
It was, yeah, but that's a good question, actually, because was it called good on the back line? So what if it's out there and good on...
Well, if it's either it's out or it's out or not.
Yeah, true, yeah. It will show in and out. That's going to be interesting. That's perfect. You can't make a better shot than that.
challenge successful. Two challenges. Remaining.
So the challenge was good. Nguyen's problems 17, continue. 17-13, as you heard the scoreline now. And an important little run of 3 points here from Wang. Has separated herself from her opponent from Hong Kong.
Over 14-17.
You know, we came to the World Championships obviously 2010-2011, clean sweep from China, wasn't it?
Yeah,
5 out of 5. Just feels like in the last few years, you know, we've seen the number one seeds go out today from China in the women's doubles. That
there is
there's a few more gunning, isn't
yeah,
there for
is.
Them?
There's a few more gunning, which is good for badminton, I think. Of course,
oh my goodness.
He's a fantastic character, never gives up.
Lucky she didn't injure herself there, really, flinging herself about there, Queen. I mean, most would just watch it go back into the court, wouldn't they? But she actually not only got a racket to it, she nearly generated the power to get it over. In the women's singles, though, they still seem very dominant, don't they?
Yeah, but there is some new countries, there are some countries there. Thailand has
and India obviously have
India's
some.
Got some. Thailand's got some very good young players coming up. Of course, the
last year
defending world champion Ratchanok. So
although she doesn't feel fully at it, does she, Ratchanok?
Oh, but let's see when she gets in there. If she's here, if she plays, we have to consider her ready. So. Oh, that's a good shot.
Yeah, brilliant.
And you have that feeling now that 19, Yip has run out of solutions here. That she's really, really done her best, but it hasn't been enough. And in my book, if I had to analyze it once, she should have had that first game here. It's going to be very, very difficult from now on here. All the long rallies she's losing. She's got to come up with something like this all the time, and that's very, very difficult.
15-19. Game point, 15.
Yeah, 5 game points for Wang Shixian. Just missed the line. So, a good test, you have to say, for Wang here, but she's overcome the obstacle in that first game, at least, from Ip Huiyin, and the number two seed halfway there as far as making the next round is concerned.
To 20 seconds.
So backhand, look at that. That's an amazing shot. What can you, what can you do?
Nothing really is the answer.
Look, just
she's
look
fighting
at this.
So hard, isn't
just
she?
Just look at that.
Point.
She's almost. It's a perfect shot.
The start that Wang wanted, sucking out the hopes of Ip Huiyin here.
It's a tough thing for her now with that gap. It's, you know, she can maybe make a point here and there where she wins it, but it's still too long away. So, but I still think I like the idea. I like the plans he came out with. So.
Thank you.
1 point.
One, 5.
Well, important point in terms of just giving her a little bit of a morale lift, boost, but 5-1 down. One game down already. Up against an opponent who's classy and playing well. It's a long road here for Ipuyin. Another one that was perfectly into the back quarter. Just giving her the runaround, isn't she, really?
Yeah, she's pretty much in all areas of the game right now. She's in control one. So. And there's nothing more difficult right now for Yip. She of course had exactly the same feeling.
6-1.
Losing point after point, then you feel the tiredness more as well, don't you?
The real tying thing for her right now is that right there, that smash, that's a lot of energy you have to use it. That's in. But the most tying thing for her is that she constantly feels that she's a step behind. And there's nothing more tying than that in badminton. We just have that feeling, you can't really get into make that shot you really wanted to. It would be a little bit like when you could say the tiki-taka of Barcelona when they were at their best, where the opponent teams were just running around and they never touched the ball. It's a little bit the same. Very tiring. Of course, here she gets to touch the shuttle, but I hope the viewers get the picture.
No, totally. There's one in control and one chasing.
Yeah. Great shot. Great disguise shot.
Serve is over. 9-3.
Yeah, sometimes I wonder why one does have this tendency. I mean, it's part, you know, it's not like she's putting on for today's match. She does that generally, but is it always that necessary when you're so far ahead, 21-15, 9-3? I can understand if it's a tight match and it's a big point.
Yeah, I think it's different from person to person, you know. I think it's part of her game. Just telling everybody in the arena that she's made a good shot. And then again, as an opponent, of course, it can be really frustrating to listen to.
Yeah, she celebrates every point. Watch at the end of this one, even a little fist pump here. It's like it's.
But that's the game.
It's
today.
Automatic for her. There you go.
It used to be more as the style of the Asian players. Now it's come to the whole world. They're using it, so it's. Even that there hasn't been, let's say there's a serve into the net and there will be shouting. And
at least we haven't got what tennis has got, which is the grunting at every shot.
Every shot, but it's between after every rally, you know. So and some can think that's too much. Daft just think it's part of the game now. And but I definitely have been from a little bit older than these players playing now, maybe way older than these players now. I don't know how to put them. Probably make me quite aggressive.
It would wind you up, I think. Yeah.
It would probably cause a yellow card or something like that. So, but that's the style there is today, and I just think the most important thing is the challenges we got under Hawkeye, where you would have seen players try and shout if it was out, they would try to shout it in, and
five.
Now that's been taken away. And I really love that. It's a good development Badminton has done there.
Well, Wang Shixian has overcome a very good opponent here, and she's kind of in cruise control, really. 21-15, 11-5 it is at the interval. She lost in the quarterfinals of the World Championships last year, Wang, losing in straight games to PV Sindhu. Of course, she was number one in the world in 2011. Good for Wang Shixian, looking good for her reported boyfriend on the court next door as well, Chen Long. 17-9 up early stages against Max Wiebler of Germany.
Yeah, both would be happy tonight.
Expecting that.
Serve is over. 7-6.
Well, it doesn't matter given the scoreline, but you wouldn't know it from her reaction, would you?
No. Jeez. Just there, but
17-7.
It's fine.
17.
That's right.
Serve is over. 8-17.
Able to put a few more points on the board here, Ipuyin, but I'm afraid it's a lost cause for her. It's going to be 9 matches now against Wang Shixian and 9 painful defeats. She won't want to play her again anytime soon, will she?
10th anniversary soon. Yeah, but you can see why it's difficult for you, but you know, Wang Jian is just not the opponent she likes to play against. You know, she can pretty much get all the good shots back that Yip comes up with. Even though I think Yip has done really, really well here, she just have a difficulty playing against Wang. So it wouldn't surprise me if it would happen again. And then maybe Yip needs to go home and say, if I'm to beat her, oh, that's fantastic. And beat Wang, what do I need
11,
to 17. Improve? And in that department, I think she needs to improve the basic of the game and be able to say, okay, if you start clearing like this, I'm just gonna start clearing back and I can follow you all the way.
11,
because if Wang knows that she can always just get out of it by this punch clear to around the head side, then she's pretty comfortable. That's a great backhand. It's definitely not giving up.
No, she's won the last 4 points. Yeah. Here we
go. Well, that's some of her own medicine.
Serve is over. 18, 11.
it's fantastic, right?
Serve is over. Yes. 12, 18.
This time she didn't get it.
So I deserve that. 9, 10, 12. One.
Still a pretty comfortable score, and we're still up to around, we're around these 47 minutes. It's
thank you.
Just shows you that if Yip is to have a chance of beating Wang, she has to work on her stamina. Back in.
14-19.
Well, it's been a feature of the match, isn't it? It wasn't going to go down without a fight. She's every point she's won, she's worked so hard for. Deserves a lot of credit, as you say. You know, she's nearly 50 minutes on court now with the world number two.
Yeah. But had she showed this believing, you know, now it feels like she can run for days. So maybe it's a mentality thing, you know. He's playing really, really well now, and Wang seems to be having problems finding the solutions. Can't call that one. It for my eyes, and if I played, I would say out.
Yeah, I agree with that.
I would say out.
Just if it is out, then there'll be match points for Wang.
But it could make it real interesting if that challenge was unsuccessful. There we go. That's in.
It's in, yeah.
Oh!
Challenges.
You know it was close when you have to go in for the double closer. So match points 20. It is for Wang Xian.
15.
Oh, that's unlucky.
Hu Titrang awaits in the last 16. She had a walkover against Eriko Hirose today.
Not over yet.
Serve is over. 16-20.
I really think she's been playing a great game here. Yep, in the comeback. You can't help wondering why didn't she show this kind of, you know, game from the start. She doesn't look tired at all. It's going wide.
17-20.
It's not.
I'm
wondering if
she doesn't.
She
doesn't look tired at all.
No, she looks like she's comfortable. She doesn't want to change the shuttle. She's, you know, where was this ship from the start?
One.
It could be too late.
But it does look. I mean, it's still three match points.
Yeah, but Wang has really, really found it difficult to score the points right now. And that's
there's
wide.
Another one that's wide. Hello.
18, 20.
Hello. Wow. 18-20 it is. How small was it from being 19 points all? So tight, wasn't it, that challenge?
Oi.
She's got it back
come
again.
Come on.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
What a point. Well, what a way to end the match.
What a fantastic rally.
And I think that sums up what we've seen from Ip Hui in here. I think the crowd applauding her as much as they are Wang Xian here because...
Big time.
She made a real fight of this.
That has to be the best rally of the tournament so far.
Certainly the best one to end the match.
21-18.
Still have to go back to our men's doubles earlier that maybe just top that.
Oh, yeah, the cool one, of course. But look at how many she gets. And that's really good shots by Wang. This one, then this one, out of balance, gets it back. Under pressure again. Yes, fantastic. And this one.
She was on the floor every couple of seconds, wasn't she? And then maybe just mentally...
But this one, that's actually when she's in the most balanced in the rally and she makes the mistake. So
trying to play a winner.
Yeah.
It was red as well by Wang, too. Still, it's Wang Xian who's through to the third round, the last 16 in the women's singles. But an excellent match that, well, she was always in command of, but was made to work, as this final point showed. Scoreline 21-15, 21-18. There's confirmation of that scoreline. So there we go. It's the seeds who have made it through in the three matches we've just seen. Wonder if that will still be the way in our fourth match in here. But with myself, Richard Kaufman, and Jim Laugesen, as we welcome into the arena the pair from Singapore, Chai Chard and Danny Krishnanta. Pastor Mogensen and Matthias Boat. Obviously, big favourites in this match and big favourites amongst the supporters here. Obviously, we saw them yesterday.